of fame. Your chance to shine has now come to an end. You were once a threat, you were once a victor. Brace yourself for a fatality.
It's on yet. Let me see if this is on. Okay, hi guys. This is not James MK. I work for James, and we just opened up shop down in Florida. We have the On Blast Show Home Shopping Network, and James wants us to sell all the stuff that we acquire over the years. Today, I'm going to give you just a quick rundown of some stuff that our organization and our principalities have acquired over the years. Today, we're starting off. We managed to get Armorall Extreme Shine. It's half used, but it still has some of it in there. We're going to be selling this product today for about $6. You can order it if you PayPal jamesmk@hotmail.com, and we'll ship it to you anywhere in the USA. We also have WD-40. We acquired this too. This is brand new. It's only been used. It feels like it's only been used like once or twice. But we're going to sell this for about $2. Now we're going to start moving on to some of the bigger items we have today. We acquired this stereo. It came fresh out of a car. I think it was a 96 Toyota Corolla. It has the detachable faceplate thing. It still has some of the wires hooked up to it, as you can see. We got this down in Orlando. We're selling this for about $125 today, and we were only able to get one speaker. So I mean, hopefully you have your own speaker system. And we also have since James was telling me that the FGC no longer allows vaping. But we have managed to acquire a couple of vaporizers that you could use. And you can use these vaporizers as long as you're not at a Capcom event. We also have a level. This level, we took this out of a trunk of a car in a parking lot. Down at, I can't remember, I think it's down in Orlando as well. We're selling that today. Now we're going to move to the better items we have. We have an Injustice stick, brand new acquired. We don't have the wires to it. You'll have to get the wires on your own, but we're selling this for about $90. And then we also have a Meerkat stick. As you can see here, we got a Meerkat stick. It's a Street Fighter Cross Tekken stick we're selling. And we got this other Fight Stick Pro, which is a Street Fighter stick. We're selling this today too. This has all the wires in it. It got dropped when we broke the window. It's got some glass, but it still functions. We've tested it. for all you Smash players out there, we got a Nintendo 3DS, and it comes with the Super Smash game, as you can see here. So, you know, for all you Smash players, you could still play your Smash while you're on the go. We're selling this for about $170. We also acquired some miscellaneous stuff. We got like headset wires and stuff like that. We only did about 13 cars today, but we were looking to increase it by the end of the weekend. As you know, you can reach out to James MK at theonblastshow.com, and he will send it to you. But I just wanted to say, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for leaving your stuff in your cars. Thank you very much.
Hey guys, what's up? I'm back. I don't know what that was all about, but I wanted to give a shout out to all those going down to CEO this weekend. It was so far it's been a pretty good experience. I just want to represent my EVB boys, EVB Bizzle, you know, who I asked him if he wanted me to sponsor him and put his name up in the stream, and he said no. So I figured, what a better place to wear his shirt. This is my Game of Thrones thing right now. I don't know how I acquired this shirt, but he went to cry to a couple of people about my show, and then he said my show's toxic. So I figured I'd represent EVB, because I've always represented the Florida players the best I could. So shout outs to EVB this weekend at CEO. So anyway, guys, you bet I'm from Long Island, huh, Paul? You bet right I'm from Long Island. So anyway, guys, you know, I see a lot of people bitching and moaning about CEO. And I'm joking around, of course. I mean, I don't wish nobody to have a miserable time. I hope the event went without hitches. I mean, I don't want to say day one was karma, but it kind of was karma for what was done to final round. And this is the reason why you don't go out there and put it out there and bitch and moan and groan. Because it could easily come back in your face at the same time. Mewtwo King Catfish dropped out of CEO. Really? I didn't hear the whole thing. I heard about the catfishing. Let me add in a couple of people here. We're going to bring in Crying Brian to start. Where's Mr. Crying Brian? Shut your mouth. Shut your mouth. You're not down at CEO, man?
No, I didn't really have the time or money or whatever.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat. So what do you think of it so far?
I have not been watching because, you know, I was hanging out with some friends, doing some tabletop gaming, etc.
Haven't watched nothing. So Mewtwo King was getting catfished, dropped.
Holy shit, man! That is like some of the craziest news for the Smash community I have heard in a while. And by news, I mean drama. And by drama, I mean like the kind I can look at from a distance because it doesn't really affect me.
Exactly. Like, that's the way I am.
Oh man, I don't wish bad on the guy.
No, I don't either, but I mean, it seems like it's
it's sad that it happened, but now that it's already done and over with and he probably knows, man, dude.
So how? This person was a really big troll from what I've seen on it?
No, he's a transgender.
Holy shit.
You know, but you know, I mean, I feel bad.
That's like the worst Christmas present unwrapping.
Unless you're looking for a fucking red rocket.
Well, then that's another story.
But, you know, I mean, it's for him to drop out of CEO is not good. I mean, I guess it's the embarrassment. And this is something that it does need to get addressed in the FGC, because the FGC as a whole is kind of
Immature?
No, open to everything, but it's now gotten to the point where it's open to everything, and anybody that doesn't vibe with whatever's considered open now is labeled. And it's like, you know, how do you deal, you know, if that's embarrassing to you, then it's embarrassing to you. I mean, that's pretty much what it was. He probably thought he was kicking it with a girl the whole time, found out it was a dude, and then went, oh, shit. And then, you know, you got the whole crowd pointing fingers, ha-ha, you didn't know? You know, and the embarrassment of that, which is something that I think transgenders need to also understand, that it's not only them, you know, that is affected. You know, I mean, obviously a transgender is affected more, especially how they identify, but a straight dude thinking he's picking up a girl only to find out that she's in the process or half the process or even the completed process.
Except, like, I don't think Mewtwo King would have figured it out on his own.
No.
Because for all he knew, this girl was dead. Like, they played the good old, I'm bored with this ruse now, so I'm going to say I'm dying of a disease catfish play. It was, man.
Yeah.
So he would have gone through months of thinking that, like, oh man, this would have been the girl I was really going to be with, and she's never coming back, and I don't know. I mean, it's better that he knows, like, obviously, so we can...
No, it's very real
kinda,
drama. It's very real drama for somebody that has Asperger's. That already has quote unquote a disability as far as learning. I don't even know if it's considered learning. But he has a disability, you know, and not to shine a light on his disability, but people also got to understand that certain people react differently to certain things.
Definitely not all high-functioning autistic people, but a whole lot of them certainly have, like, an air of gullibility to them, so
yeah.
I guess they just thought Mewtwo King would be an easy target.
Oh, damn.
People really got to be watching his back at all times, you know, all of his friends and stuff. Like, some people have suggested, like, somebody, like, on, like, his sponsor team has some kind of, like, guy that helps him out with stuff and make sure he's not getting into trouble and stuff. Because back when Smash wasn't as big as it was now and people weren't staying at hotels, they were just staying at their local friend's house and driving 5 hours to go places, it seemed like everybody had a Mewtwo King story of, like, oh man, Mewtwo King stayed at my friend's place and he did this really weird thing. I don't know why he did that.
And, well, I mean, I have, I have Mewtwo King stories, but you know, it's and it's stuff that I've dealt with directly with him, and sometimes I feel like, you know, this is why I kind of hate the Smash community, because you got jerk offs like this fucking scumbag Leffen, who go around talking shit all high and mighty, and you know, Mewtwo King kind of gets treated like Carrie.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and I'm just waiting for the day that, you know, Mewtwo King lashes back at them. And then, and again, I reiterate this. I don't condone it, but I won't blame him. You know, and the part about it that's sad is I don't blame him, and I feel pity for him, not them. Because they're going to be the ones that go, well, why did you have to react that way? You know, and I've said it a million times to people. You know, somebody on Facebook had made a post. And they said something to the effect of, if you knew somebody didn't like you, would you walk away or would you want to know why? And everybody had their answers. Some said walk away. Some said, you know, I'd want to know why. I said, I want to destroy their life. Everything about them. I don't want to know why. I don't want to walk away. I want you to suffer.
At the very least, I think Mewtwo King, in the next few events, if he's not feeling like he's going on the right path, he could at the very least destroy people in tournament bracket, because in the past year or so, the crowd has actually been behind him, like rooting for this guy that used to dominate all these tournaments and for him to, like, finally come back to form and be the guy again. And that's kind of exciting to see if he can make that comeback.
I mean, it definitely
I believe it could happen. I believe it could happen. Anything that has a situation that has occurred before probably end up basically biting people in the ass later on.
He's going to come back from this weird fucking situation. He's going to come back stronger and maybe even affect his mindset for the game and get better at that somehow. I don't know.
I feel that it's more likely experience for people. Like, if they, like, since pretty much, if it's probably new to him, then more likely he's going to end up basically adapting to it. And then it's going to take some time, of course. But then more likely, they'll overcome it.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm hearing the pool party got canceled.
Because I guess the 13 cars?
Well, yeah, the 13 cars were getting broken into. I mean, I know I'm selling all this cool stuff here. No correlation. I'm up in New York, guys. I'm selling this stuff here, you know, like car stereos, joysticks, armor roll, cigarettes, lighters, cars, wires, and everything. It has nothing to do with what happened down at CEO. It just so happened to be the night I chose to sell my products.
Like, there's been enough, you know, mass car break-ins happening at events that at first when there was like two events where this happened, I was thinking it might be a coincidence of, okay, somebody that like knew the event was happening but not necessarily part of like the fighting game scene just saw that opportunity and took it. But now it's happened enough times that I'm really thinking that it's somebody that goes to these events.
You know, I tend to agree. And again, you know, I'm not pointing fingers and setting up witch hunts. But I will say this, and it sounds fucked up, but none of this shit got stolen until the Smash community got added in.
Oh, yeah, because I'm not too sure if this is what this was still confirmed. Remember the thing that I basically posted about the whole television sets?
Yeah.
About somebody because this is what I found weird, and I still question this till this time. Okay, so one morning, I found out, you know, I was slightly bored. I found out that there was a tweet about somebody requesting a television. And long story short, apparently, you know, I kind of questioned that the fact that why did they post on Twitter if they could be able to post it on Facebook and be connected with people on Facebook other than Twitter, so it doesn't get misconstrued that somebody stole that person's television. You know what I mean? Like,
well, you got to remember, Smash players play on CRTs. Everywhere else has got flat screens.
True. Yeah.
So that's, you know, that's my thing with that. It's like, you know, you can't buy a CRT no more. You got to pick up somebody's shit that they throw out for special pickup, and you hope it works. And that's what the Smash community does. But, you know, I mean, Highcraft said Jeff Bailey got interviewed on all the local news media. That's just calling thieves to it. You know, listen, guys, I'm sorry. Florida, I love my MK guys down there, but y'all in meth head capital of the world.
And especially that there was already been a controversy with that club that happened. So for the fact that it's happening two weekends in a row, it's really getting awful now.
You know, and it's like, you know, and it's not, and again, no event is beholden to it. You know, there's something that happens at everybody's event. This is why when he went and called people out, I was like, man, you're just asking for karma to knock on your door. I mean, we're only, what, 2:30 in the morning on fucking Saturday morning, and two fire alarms have gotten pulled. You got fucking 13 cars getting broken into, a stream that sounded like this the whole day. The whole fucking time when I was listening to it, you know, I just heard a grounding hum the whole event, you know, and I hope it gets better. You know, I hope it gets better. For somebody that boasted bigger numbers, I know last year the Smash community was asked to leave because the fire marshal came down. You know, one more fire alarm pole and that fire marshal's going to come down. And this time it's going to be the chief. And he's going to go, wait a second, you got more than you had in last time. You already stated for the record you have more people. You know, so it's going to get ugly. You know, my mic is fine, man. My mic is fine.
Well, actually, what I think happened was when you were making the fake like buzzing sound and you were getting really close to the mic and it was really loud. So I think some kind of auto volume changing kicked in. It also for me, yeah. I heard you really quietly for a little bit there, but it's good now. It's good now.
All right, it's good now. I just gotta I don't know. I gotta tweak this shit. I sounded like the CEO stream. Sorry, man.
Well, here's the good news too. From what I found out, that for Street Fighter V streams, Capcom Fighters is going to be handling that. So for those that are looking for Street Fighter V, you've been saved for now.
Well, I mean, that's good. You know, it's good. It's good that again. I know everybody knows that me and Alex aren't like the bestest of buddies. I don't hate the dude. You know, we see things differently, but I still want him to have a good event. The reason I don't care about Alex. I care about the people that go to the event. You know, people have paid good money to come to this event. And, you know, the least they should do is be able to get what they're expecting. Now, the pool party being closed is another thing. I don't know what happened with that, why it got closed early or whatever. From what I was... James, I'm pretty drunk. Is it okay if I call in? Sure, D-Bot, call in. But, you know... I don't anticipate any hiccups tomorrow. You know, because at this point he's got to be on his like ultra A game, and these guys ain't getting no sleep tonight.
I ain't sleeping after that, and for the fact that I'm still like contaminated with freaking Pepsi. No way, no how.
This is getting way too good. I'm going to sleep. I could tell you that right now. I'm not doing an all-nighter with this show. This is just a hiccup. I just had to push some products. that's about it. Guys, if you really want to buy some of these products, you know, make me an offer. You can hit me up at jamesmk@hotmail.com. Anything that says Florida on it, don't believe it. It's really from New York. I got some car decals and stuff like that I picked up. I got a car battery if you need a car battery. What else do I got? I'm trying to think what else I got. I got some used condoms if you guys are into that.
Just don't pull Charlie Sheen.
I didn't say I'm giving you AIDS.
Well, the person getting AIDS from using it for protection.
I ain't telling you what's in it. I put battery acid in it.
Oh, used condoms are for protection? I thought they were for some sort of sick fantasy fulfillments.
No.
That can be another addition.
I just use them to fill shit up with it. That's it.
Have a water balloon fight, man.
I've had water balloon fights. I had semen fights. Like, I jerked off in a water balloon for like a month. Oh, and then God. When my neighbor came out the house, I was like, water balloon fight, smash. She's like, what kind of water is this? I said, I made it.
It's cold water.
And then he was like, I've been waiting for you to say that for 3 years. Then he pulls out 5 water balloons filled with semen, and then you have a big old
And then we had a big time. Fucking, we had a big fucking Navy SEAL fight. But, yeah, used condoms have candy in it. Exactly, Socorro. You know what? It's amazing because I don't understand. Like, mine has these things in it. It's like they're like Pez. I don't know why. Has everybody got that when they?
I hear that happens when you.
I think it's with age.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, time out. So wait, Pez is still a thing at this time?
Well, no. Jeez. I'm just trying to make you. Why make Pez? That's the thing.
Pez still exists. You can buy that in stores.
Holy shit!
Yeah, dude. I mean, they still make Pez dispensers of somewhat relevant media properties.
So wait, let's change the subject here. So, Brian, what have you been up to, man? It's been a long time since you've been around.
Well, I've just been taking it easy a little bit, doing some work, doing some school, doing some buttfuck nothing. When it comes to fighting-ish games... In February, for my birthday, I went all the way to Portland, Oregon.
Jesus.
just so I could go to the Naruto tournament at the Wizard World Comic Con, okay, because I thought it would be funny because I hate that game.
And how'd you do?
I got second place.
Something wrong with that?
I thought, you see, I went in thinking I would get first place, which was pretty naive of me because although I'm somewhat experienced with those games, I didn't really do the homework necessary to like really dig deep into the game. So,
Smash Brothers? Talk about Smash Brothers?
No, it's Naruto.
Oh.
So okay. Then I waited for the St. Louis, Missouri event and drove all the way there. But by then, I had done my homework on the game. I figured out a lot of dumb shit. I figured out how other people play the game. I had it down pat. And I went there and I pretty easily took first place in that one.
You kicked the ass.
But here's where things got a little bit silly. The person that actually won the first one actually went to the one in St. Louis as well, so he was kind of like me, wanting to go to a lot of them.
Yeah.
And I didn't end up fighting him at all because the second place person.
No, so what game was this?
This was Naruto Ninja Storm 4.
PS2 is the PS2 version PS4. Or PS4? Okay.
PS4. And the second place guy was he actually has a moderate amount of like subscribers on YouTube for like the people that actually like these fucking games. Mm-hmm. They guess they watch him or whatever. And after I got back home from the tournament and stuff, the like 2 days after, he actually made a video about the experience and stuff. And basically, he called me the hell out for intentionally abusing a really dumb bug that was in the game at the time. It was, I suppose the best way I can explain it is that game is mostly around meter management, and you have a meter that tells you how many bursts you can do, and if you don't use bursts for a while, you get them all back. Okay, it's based on a timer. So what I did was a really weird bug where I switch and tag out characters at the right time that basically lets me get my bursts back whenever the fuck I want.
Okay, so did he do that?
Well, because I met the guy the day before the tournament at the venue, I thought, man, this guy's a really personable guy. I kind of want to become friends with him. And although I went in wanting to win, I'm also a guy that really likes fun. So I showed him how to do the thing. And I'm like, here's this thing I found out. It's really weird. It seems like a game breaker, but it's more like a game changer. Let me show you how to do it. And so I wanted him to kind of experiment with it so he could do it against me. And we could have like a real final fight of the game at its highest kind of ish level. Of course, because he's kind of a stubborn guy that doesn't want to use broken things. No, he wants to play legit. He then gets his ass stomped.
What is legit?
Here's the thing. There is no legit unless both people are on the equal playing field. But if somebody's stupid enough not to use the shit knowing you're going to use
exactly.
it, then fuck him.
Basically,
use every broken thing you can.
He basically crippled himself by not using the thing I showed him how to do. He made a video about it saying that, like, oh, he felt like he got his victory robbed from him, etc. Or that, like, he felt like I went to the tournament just
bullshit. So you outplayed him. You outplayed him.
Yeah, I did most of the time. But he claimed that I went to the tournament just so I could basically troll the whole thing by abusing a broken thing, which, you know what, he was actually right about that one.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I did get free money. I mean, about that
shit. Listen, let me tell you something. Every person, listen to PO half the time. I'm going to go to this event. I got secret tech. He ain't going there to show it, to say, hey guys, everybody, check out the secret tech. He's here to win the tournament with the secret tech, and then when it's all over, go, oh, by the way, if you really want to know how to do this, let me show you now that I got first place.
Well, I'll get back to you on that point, but basically then I went there, I went home, and then the guy that got third place, after he found out about what the bug was, because I didn't teach him, but he found out on his own later by like rewatching the footage, or maybe the other guy told him, he actually like posted a thing on Twitter being like, oh man, anybody that uses such and such glitch must have no self-confidence, whatever. So I'm like, okay, he's definitely talking about me. This is actually kind of funny.
I feel like the glitch is the coolest part about fighting games, you know?
Yeah. In a lot of ways. Yeah, so now
find the most broken stuff in the game. I think that's the most. That's the greatest part about fighting games.
I think it's 1 month. The next Wizard World tournament with a Naruto in it is in my hometown of Columbus, so I'm definitely going to that.
The Cavs won, right? Cavs won.
If any of these guys show up, you see the game actually got patched, and surprise, surprise, the glitch I was using over and over intentionally was fixed. So that's no longer there. But I've found some other dumb shit. And rest assured, I'm not going to tell them about it until after, because the look on their faces will be completely fucked.
Listen, you don't play fighting games to lose. You know, it's everybody loses, but a lot of people win, you know.
More or less, I actually play this Naruto game and are going to these events because I hate it and I want people to know that it's a bad game.
And so you keep winning and proving it a bad game.
Oh, not only winning, but winning in a way that's fucking stupid.
I just missed the GameCube version of Naruto.
Well, about that, they actually gave me the mic in St. Louis, Missouri. And when I got the mic, I said, hey, this game is pretty all right. It might have a few more patches to go, but if you want a really competitive Naruto experience, you should check out the GameCube games instead.
Dude, when you had the mic, did you sing?
No, but it's great. I won a tournament in a game, and then minutes afterward, dissed the game. I just won.
You have to do me a favor. The next one you win in Columbus, when they give you the mic, you gotta be my Baba Booey, and when you get on the mic, you just look at the crowd. You just look at the crowd. You give them deadest stare.
Hey now.
And you get silent and count to like 10 seconds, and then just go OBS, James MK Baba Booey, and drop the mic and walk away.
Now a lot of people might say that dissing the game you just won live on stage is particularly poor form, especially considering like community people from Namco Bandai were at this event watching, but I was particularly not giving a fuck.
I had no idea that that game you were playing was competitive. That's crazy.
Well, it's not, because there are absolutely no grassroots tournaments.
Yeah, no.
Because I've never actually seen any. The people that are supposedly good at the game, for whatever reason, are satisfied with playing online, which is dumb. I've told so many people after I beat them, like people after I've played them online, people have told me, oh man, the way you play is like so innovative and weird. I don't know why you're doing the things you're doing. And I tell them, because I'm doing things that only work offline.
Do you have fans?
They're playing a different game than me.
Damn.
When I was at this tournament, people were doing stuff on me that only works offline. Like, oh no, I can just beat this every time on reaction. Stop doing that. It's like a lot of like MK players' first tournaments when they do stuff that is ridiculously risky and unsafe, and you can immediately tell who the online players are, that kind of thing. Yeah. Except everyone was an online player except for me.
You know what's the complete issue just with games in general? Is that because I kept on hearing this on the CEO stream, and I even post this on Twitter. Never say that you're a serious gamer or a serious insert video game that you play here. Because for some flipping fucking reason, it pretty much robs the enjoyment and the satisfaction of how much you enjoy with the game. Because every single time, not just only during streams, but even in publishing, like Event Hubs or SRK, they always, when they do an interview with a person, they ask, are you serious into fighting games? To me, that shit's a red flag. And I've been basically spotting this every flipping time, like, with just pretty much social media overall.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I kind of just want to hit some buttons, see some stuff on the screen, and have fun.
Listen, every motherfucker that I listen to when they say they're a professional gamer, honestly, I
think they're not.
They're slightly autistic. Because, you know what? To say that would mean you're making a livable wage, and there was some professional training you received to do this, or some vetting process.
Yeah, as they're saying, I'm a professional, you know, whatever it is, you know, I'm professional this, I'm professional that. Professional gamer? Man.
I love Justin Wong, and he's probably one of the best I think he is the best Street Fighter guy.
Probably.
Here. He's one of the best.
But
he's
beats 5 9-year-olds in a tournament to get to the finals. Now, he beats other players as he moves up.
This dude almost destroyed the whole Rumble tonight.
Who did he finally lose to?
He lost to LPN.
Did he lose to LPN?
The thing is, is that he could have kept on if he would have had a break. But since he didn't, it was like, it was already done. He just probably tapped out.
Yeah, but wasn't he going for like 4 hours?
It seemed like, because I had seen like that. It felt that way. It's just like,
I mean, I'm glad. Like, what did I miss?
Oh, he's still playing.
And I seen Shine blow up the Japanese team. You know, I caught that. Beat Daigo easily.
My opinion is SF5. I mean, I really do like the game a lot. When I think about it, I hate it. But when I start playing it, I really do like it.
Yeah, I'm in the same way. When I play the game, I enjoy it. I ain't gonna lie. But I'll tell you, I play KI more than I play Street Fighter now.
Yeah.
And the guy who hates Keats's guts is playing his game.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, damn.
You know, but I gotta say, the game's fun. It's more fun than Street Fighter to me.
I'm actually going to go back and play Ultra Street Fighter 4 because their ranking matches as
well. I heard Daigo say that in a year that nobody will be playing Street Fighter 5 in a year.
And I said that too, so I agree.
Well, that's not quite what he said, but you might be able to infer that.
It was what he was basically saying. Since there's no arcade game for it.
Exactly.
No.
After Evo, it's going to fizzle out, and I tend to agree.
I'm a big fan of sticking to the games you love. So while you guys are gonna be playing like your Street Fighter 6s and your KOF 18s, I'm gonna be playing Jackie Chan Fists of Fire.
Damn.
With like two other guys online, and that's it.
Wow, that's a hell of a game, man. Dude, I'll meet you at Evo for that game.
first to 50 in that game at Evo.
Yo, evil characters are banned. Evil characters are banned.
Who's the evil character?
No. Every character has an evil palette swap that all it does.
Oh,
it
so
adds
you mean like evil Jackie?
Yeah. No. There's three Jackie Chans in the game, so that means there's three evil Jackie.
So what game is this? Kid, I'm gonna play this game.
Let's start getting this game going here. Jackie Chan.
Look, every character has an evil palette swap, and all it does
gives the
character one more juggle point, and that's it. The game is Jackie Chan Fists of Fire. It's actually like a Champion Edition upgrade to Jackie Chan the Kung Fu Master. It's really like a fast paced game that's with digitized actors, so the graphics look jank as fuck.
It sounds a bit like Shaq awesome. Fu.
It's got chain combos, man. And okay.
Not the way
it's got, you can cancel your forward dashes into like anything. But you can't cancel your back dash. They got like some thoughtful movement in there.
It's got like Mothra in it and shit.
Dude, you really?
Yeah.
It's like Godzilla and shit.
No, that's Mysterious Lion.
Oh,
Mysterious Lion.
It's got a wannabe Sonya. It's got a Bruce Lee, a Jackie Chan, a Jackie Chan, a Jackie Chan.
And more Chan.
One-third of the game's roster is Jackie Chan.
They got blue Chinese guy. They got blue. Black.
You know what game I actually did like a lot?
Characters. They got blue Chinaman, black girl, long haired white trash,
Oh, dude, that's Thorsten. He's like the best guy. That's the best guy.
Jackie Chan. Bruce Lee. Sonya Wade.
Sonya Wade.
The Sonya lookalike is actually the grappler for some reason.
And White Lion.
That guy sucks.
He looks like he sucks. I thought it was fucking Mothra.
He's like the worst guy.
Oh,
jeez.
What is this for? What system?
It's an arcade game, so your only hope is emulation, really.
Name. You know what game I really did like is Eternal Champions on Genesis.
Oh, yeah, it was a good game.
No, actually,
I mean, you
Sonya,
probably
thought... Sonya Blade's name is actually Kim Mary.
Hmm. Now, you probably thought that Eternal Champions was a good game because you might have, like, played it when you were, like, 5.
Yeah.
But,
yeah, pretty much.
First time I played it, I was, like, 16, and by then, I knew about fighting games shit, and I'm like, what is this garbage? I found an infinite within 5 minutes. It was amazing.
Sadly, I think I played it. I was about 25.
Actually, when I played also Primal Rage when I was a kid, I thought it was freaking great. Yeah, and then the thing was that when I started playing it now, I'm like, how the fuck am I supposed to play with these controls?
You use a stick.
It's great in the sense of theming and
ideas. It's a classic game. It's great.
Yeah.
All right, we want classic games. You want, like, perfect, amazing games? Mappy.
What the fuck is that?
Mappy was a mouse. It was a runaround.
I know Pong.
See, James knows. James knows. Why don't you guys know?
Because they're not as old as me.
Neither am I.
What Mappy?
I guess I know good games and they don't.
Mappy was like a cop mouse.
Listen, I don't trust the cops, but I would definitely let Mappy walk me across the street. That is a mouse you can fucking trust.
He's walking across the street. What?
Hey man, when I'm like 8, when I'm like 90 fucking years old and I can barely see 1 foot in front of me, and I fucking hear a tiny mouse at my feet saying, I can help cross the street, and there's like a fucking cat.
Well, first of all, if you're 90 years old and a mouse is talking to you saying to cross the street, you're probably getting locked up.
Listen, if a mouse sounded like Mickey
Mouse,
he's
the only guy that can protect me against the cat burglars.
Well,
they're literal cats.
Who the fuck are the cat burglars?
It's a good game. The cat burglars were the dudes that were running around CEO parking lot, robbing 13 cars. Mappy could have saved the day there.
See, look, the Namco guys were at CEO to bring Tekken 7. If they brought Mappy, these 13 cars would not have gotten broken into.
So
boom, problem solved.
Tekken 7. Boycott Tekken 7.
What the fuck are you talking about?
OBS what the fuck are you talking about? Because they didn't save a day.
Talk about Mappy.
Well, Mappy have like the Mickey Mouse voice. So I'm like, ho-ho, come cross with me across the street.
He's not Mickey Mouse.
Let's try it for a bit.
He was like an early 80s Japanese animation looking mouse.
I fucking Mappy, yo. What you want, motherfucker? I fuck you up.
Yeah,
I fuck
man.
You up. You cross street with me or I fuck kill you.
Hi guys.
You know, I'm gonna associate like a racist Asian stereotype voice with Mappy from now on.
That's all.
I won't be offended. Don't worry.
You know what's a good game, though, is Bubble Bobble.
That's some good shit.
That game is fucking legit.
How about that City Connection? City Connection? Anyone? No?
City Connection was okay.
I don't remember it.
What about Pitfall?
Jungler?
I really did like the original Terminator 2 arcade cabinet with the gun. Oh my god, that shit was so cool.
What about Pitfall?
No.
Pitfall Harry? Or Larry? Or what the fuck is that?
It's the one from the Atari.
Yo, dude, yeah. let me tell you a secret, son. If you want to beat Pitfall, here's what you do. Walk left at the start of the game, and you get some cool shit.
I think I remember that
one. It's a better path.
Is that some kind of cheat code?
No.
It's a cheat code.
Not really.
What is a cheat code?
It's a cheat code if you're stupid.
Cheat codes are pretty much at this point in gaming. Cheat codes are a way to get to finish the game you don't even want to play. faster. You pay them to.
Oh yeah, now you're just like, yo, just give me the code so I can get to the end of the game, because I really I don't want to do any of the other shit.
There's no fucking point in playing the fucking game.
So what did you guys think of Mighty Number 9?
That's garbage.
I mean, you guys are overreacting. It's okay. It's not good, but it's okay.
It's
okay.
Complete garbage.
I mean, for the money, hilarious. For the money and the way they raised it and the way they hyped it.
It was exaggerating.
Yeah.
It got delayed, how many, like 4 or 5 times over the years?
3 years?
As someone that didn't back it, and as someone that wasn't really anticipating it.
Oh, man, if I backed it, I would feel
like I'm fine. I think
a big
it's fine.
Asshole if I backed it.
I'd like fucking, you know, shoot shit. Dash shit, mash the dash button. It's good.
I mean, okay. The thing is, the reason why I said like it was exaggerating, because compared to that one and Beat Buddy, because that was a game that I had backed at the time. Compared to the development that was done in that game, it was because due to the audio that they able to make sure to be able to mix in with the gameplay, versus where you had Mighty Number 9 that was probably longer than Beat Buddy. You would expect more potential if it has been delayed for quite a long time.
There were certainly a lot of really dumb decisions when it came to like how they spent the money. That was kind of a shit show. I mean, I don't know why they thought the game needed voice acting at all.
And yeah,
why
it
they got so
sense.
Many expensive voice actors and multiple language dubbing. That was a little bit much, I think.
I think that was way too much.
Well, the gameplay too. It had a combo system to it.
Well, that's if you want points. It's about points.
I guess. Yeah, I guess you're right. Yeah.
I believe.
But that doesn't sound fun.
Mighty Number 9. Beating the level is fine, but the primary objective is to do well at the game, and the points encourage that.
But the problem with that is, look, you know, when you. Mega Man was not.
No, it wasn't.
And it had nothing to do with points. And when they tried to portray it as it going to be what Mega Man 35 should have been, but we got fucked at by Capcom and we left and did our own shit, this is what it was supposed to be. I can understand Mighty Number 9 and the whole creation of a new character and all that good shit, but the fact is, people were expecting the impact that Mega Man had. Now, I personally, right. You know, I bought Mega Man 1 before anybody bought the thing, when it was still like a sleeper hit.
Yeah.
You know, nobody knew about it. Nobody really knew
Mega Man 2 was
the
big one.
Nobody knew Mega Man until Mega Man 2. Mm. And then they went back to Mega Man 1. And I had bought Mega Man 1, and it was one of those games. You know, for me, like a good side-scrolling game, when you get to what you anticipate to be the main boss, and you're like, all right, and you go through fucking hell to beat him, and you beat him, and you're getting your, yeah, way to go, you saved everything, and then you get the, ah-ha-ha, fuck you, I was just jerking your chain. And it
play
was,
it again.
And no, that's the thing that was cool about it, because a lot of games will do that. No, that was just a dream. Now you're going to play the real game. And it's like, no, get the fuck out of here. I played the game once. You know, it wasn't a secondary playthrough. It was an actual added on, like, 2 more 3 levels left.
Hmm.
When there was a lot of hype surrounding, like, the announcement of Mighty Number 9, I think people's wallets were a little bit ahead of their brains when it says like, oh, this is a spiritual successor to Mega Man from the creator of Mega Man.
I could agree
but
to that.
People really need
that.
To
it was,
think.
It was from creator,
right.
Not the
Because
creator.
Even back then, gaming development was done with teams in almost all cases. You can't really attribute a game's creation to one
Correct
person.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but did Keiji Inafune, so he did the music and he did the character designs?
He was more or less a visionary of sorts.
Right.
If you're going to say, oh, Keiji Inafune is creating a Mega Man game, okay, I don't give a shit. Who's he hiring to make it? Like, who are the actual people making the game? What are their credentials? What companies do they work for? That's the shit we really needed to know, but nobody paid attention to.
Yep.
And that was the thing. I mean, that's like, It's equivalent. Now, we all know I worked on Mortal Kombat. Did I create Mortal Kombat? No. But it would be like me making a game and doing a crowdfund and go, from one of the makers of Mortal Kombat, yeah, I worked on the home versions.
You were a cog in the machine.
That's it. That's all I was. I was another fucking piece. You know, and to sell it that way, and people saw that, like, oh my God, I'm finally going to get my new Mega Man, my old Mega Man continuation. They should have did some research with their fucking eyes before their wallet.
Or that one fighting game Kickstarter that didn't go through from like two or some years back that was fucking stupid. The chainsaw incident, that stupid fucking thing.
Oh, that game.
One of the
What are you talking about? What game is that?
That's Thrill Kill.
You never heard about that because it didn't fucking go through. When they were talking about like, oh man, these
I just had the game. I just had the game on my computer too, the beta for it.
There were people that were like, oh, the chainsaw incident, but that I don't even know if that's still in development. But
no, it's not. They said it is again though. I was like, really?
The Kickstarter was saying stuff like, it's from some of the makers of X game and Y game. Oh, one of the people behind Tekken. Like, okay, fuck you. I looked at the credits. I looked at the names. I did my research. The guy that worked on Tekken, he did some of the animations for like three characters. What the fuck?
He wrote the manual.
That's not anything regarding the design of the game.
He translated the manual from Japanese to English.
Imagine,
because you know, you get the movie fucking production from the makers of the guy who translated the manual from Tekken from Japanese to English. We'll now bring you the best fighting game ever. Like, what?
Could I fucking hire some interns from Iron Galaxy and be like, from the QA testers that brought you Killer Instinct?
Well, we weren't actually the QA testers. We were the interns.
Whatever, something. I don't know. I spoke before I talked. Whatever.
Yeah, you know, it was another thing too. Wrong word. There was another indie game that was by the former SNK staff, Yada Garasu. That the game was like out there a little bit in like a whole bunch, like about two or three events in the North American soil. But then, like, later on, it ended up being in Japan a little, but it didn't get that much limelight because of all the backlash it was actually getting. So the group kind of got very defensive on, bringing the game out, advocating the game.
Yeah, that was a little weird. Although I did play the game, it is pretty fun, so I don't give a shit.
Yeah, it's actually a pretty good game. It's just that a lot of people say it doesn't like it because of the fact that it's the same Street Fighter Third Strike mechanics, but with different characters in it. I mean, the thing is that it's a good game, but people just more likely don't want to be able to play another Street Fighter Third Strike game indie style.
Did somebody hear Mewtwo King's speech?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Are we going to have to watch that?
No, I just want to know.
Okay.
I didn't hear it.
Oh yes, I saw that. It was like a Twitch clip of like how, like on stream he was talking about how, you know, he like, you know, he lost somebody and something. Don't ever think that your life is meaningless, etc.
Oh, shit. So I really do have a serious question for you guys. Where do you see the FGC in the next year?
Where do I see the FGC in the next year?
I really don't know, because Street Fighter V was supposed to be the big game of the FGC, and that game it sold kind of well, but nobody's playing anymore. Nobody's playing like vanilla Street Fighter IV.
It's dead. Street Fighter is dead. It's Capcom's yeah, got it's such Capcom. A shame. I mean, it is a shame because, you know, when people hear me say that, they're like, "What a dick! You're so negative." No, I just live in the real world. The game is it's not based off the FGC. It's based off of overall sales. That is what makes and breaks success. Maximilian lives in fantasy land if he thinks success is based off of Evo numbers.
Yeah.
5,000 people times $60 is not a fucking record-breaking game sale.
No, it's not.
You know, you needed the 1.4 million that they say they sold, again, they never say sell in or sell through. Sell-in means they sold 1.4 million copies to stores like GameStop.
Yeah.
Sell-through means 1.4 million bought it from GameStop. And I never heard the official number on that. Now, I'm sure the number's gone up since then some. But it's not going to go up to a rate, you know. And I see guys like Alex Vi, and they're doing their darnest to try and push it, you know. And yeah. I understand that because, you know what? This is a West Coast game. It isn't a America's game. You know, everybody else is kind of shit on if you're not part of the NorCal, SoCal scene.
Yeah, that's kind of true.
You know, you see, yeah. Even if you look at description, yeah, if you're not part of the clique, if you're not part of the clique, you're just another person. And I don't see, even with all the good stuff that they're putting in it, at this point, it's fucking too late. Those people are playing Overwatch now. Those guys are jerking off the porn. They're not playing the game no more.
There's a lot of people playing even Paragon. I mean, for fuck's sakes, I mean, there's a lot of there was like a bunch of people. Even the actual developers from Epic Games like came paid a visit to my stream, just started giving away keys. And the only thing I was doing throughout the whole time was just advocating gameplay before the full game comes out.
And even then, the people that are fighting game enthusiasts, most of my friends that love fighting games, they're going to play Street Fighter V for about one more month, then fuck off to go play KOF 14 for a while.
Yeah, and there's going to be people going to be playing Guilty Gear Xrd, Tekken 7 soon.
And if you look at Capcom Pro Tour, you know, is a perfect example. And I'm not against them, but I don't know who the fuck is making decisions for them. Today, 8 frames was intentional. Tomorrow, it wasn't. This controller works good, but this one don't. We're going to give you a story mode. We're going to give you this character this month. Oh, wait, maybe next month. Oh, wait, now we're going to give you a super-duper story mode, and we're going to let you see it. I don't want to see it now.
I don't even give a fuck about the story mode. I could really care less.
I do. I do. Japan
actually makes the decisions.
There should have been an arcade version and the Japanese version. There should have been an arcade version.
This is why Sony should take every fucking penny they gave them back and say, good luck with Resident Evil 7, guys.
Pretty
much. Oh, my God. Resident Evil 7. Jesus.
You know, I mean, and what will happen is Capcom will go bankrupt. The team that did Street Fighter will get bought by Sony, and you'll have Street Fighter by Sony. And that's all they'll focus on. And instead of giving them a deadline that goes to whenever, they're going to say, you have 4 years, make the game, get it done. If you don't, you're fired.
The funny thing is that it would actually be funny if Sony would have done a better job than the Street Fighter team.
Nah, I don't know about that. Sony... doesn't have a good track record when it comes to fighting. Fighting games are a different animal as far as development altogether. It actually takes a unique team of people to do a good fighting game. I mean, we've all seen...
Especially a port.
Yeah. We've seen games like Pit Fighter, you know, fucking all those crappy Bloodstorms and all the other killer time killers.
Tongue of the Fat Man.
Tattooed Assassins.
I mean, they were actually smart enough to take Kojima in.
Yeah.
So at the very least.
That game looks incredible. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to buy it.
If you want an example of a bad fighting game made by an otherwise pretty darn good developer, you'd have a Shaq Fu, which is made by Delphine Software. And those guys are pretty good.
Are you saying
Shaq
Fu is bad?
Yes, I'm saying Shaq Fu is bad. But Delphine Software made some really fucking good shit back in the day. They just couldn't make fighting games.
No, and that's the thing.
Well, they made Shaq Fu.
Shaq 2 starring fucking Dwayne Wade.
Shaquille O'Neal, right?
No, it's going to be, what's his name? Fucking
Michael Jordan.
LeBron James.
No, LeBron James.
Oh, the champion?
The champion.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't it supposed to be a Shaq Fu 2? And that was like years ago that they announced it.
Yeah. Still coming out someday. But it's just a beat 'em up, so who gives a shit?
Anybody that actually pledged that game is a fucking troll, because nobody really wants Shaq Fu 2. Nobody fucking wants that game.
If you actually, like, at E3 showed a trailer for Shaq Fu 2, would you not be the most embarrassed? Like,
I think I'll be baffled.
First up, we have VR, and we're going to go through Walking the Dead. Okay, holy shit, this is crazy. Next game comes out, KI4, with new super-duper ultra graphics and high explosives. And these fucking losers over here got Shaq Fu. Put your shit on, dude.
And he actually breaks the rim in gameplay.
That shit cracks me up. That shit, so funny. You know, but so I have a joke for you guys. I have a joke. I have a quick joke.
All right.
So I
13 cars.
This guy goes to the library and he asks the librarian for a book on suicide. The librarian says, "Fuck you, you won't bring it back."
What?
Yeah.
But then the wait a minute. Then the late fees on the book would eventually build up and the debt would be passed on.
I think you missed the joke. I think you missed the joke.
No, they'd make the library would make more money, wouldn't they?
I guess.
I got your joke, but yeah, apparently the library would keep charging for it, and then they would go after his kids and say, "You owe us X amount of dollars."
Right,
now.
Because when somebody with
that's
debt dies, the debt becomes inherited. You know, family can get fucked. Like, I don't know. I don't
even
know
if
shit.
If it was my family and they handed the bill to me, I would just stab the librarian to death and say, "I paid it."
No witnesses.
Exactly. I gave it to her. I don't know what she did with the money. She didn't put it in the register. She's dead now. Somebody took it. Ain't my fault. I paid it. Gotta go.
You gotta write a letter in blood.
I paid my debt.
In the library.
So, I know that the monsters here, these perfect strangers, the monsters on the chat were asking about the talk about the 13 cars and all those other types of stuff, which I think.
I gotta confess. It was a 2006 Maxima, okay? And it was a gold
Nissan
one.
Maxima?
Yeah, it was a gold one. With tinted windows, and it had those stupid spinny rims on them. But I broke the one rim because I got annoyed because it was hard to get in the car.
Oh, Jesus.
Then it was a 2001 Lexus. It didn't have anything in it. So I just smashed the windows because I was pissed that they had nothing good to take. Then they had the one, hate the stereotype, but it must have been a black dude, the car, because it had fucking buckets of Popeyes in it. And it was all half-eaten shit, and they ate all the white meat, so I didn't touch that. I didn't really go into many of the cars. There was a 1992 Oldsmobile, which, to be honest, it had to have been a Smash Players, because ain't nobody else would drive that shit box. But they had that stereo that I got that I was auctioning off today.
Oh, yeah, hit crack. When you said it's unsecured debt and it's not inherited, well, pretty much soon enough, if Donald Trump dies, apparently his daughter and his wife will probably have to take hold of that.
That's irrelevant.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But this means also Donald Trump's campaign is irrelevant.
Let Jim finish the story.
Yeah, bro.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, dude.
Why you got my dog. Moment, man?
Hey, what
now
the
I don't
fuck,
remember
dude?
What I only did five cars. I still got like another. Yeah, it was an Impala. Actually, you're right. The Impala had fucking Popeye's chicken in it.
Did was Sherry Jenks in there?
Yo, dog, but the fact that it was 13 broken into cars, that's really spooking the shit out of me. Man, it's a really foreboding number, you know?
That's the number I represent. I'm the 13 apostles that are coming to destroy the FGC. I'm the first one. I'm death.
You're taking seven.
Pestilence will be coming soon. Gluttony's here. We can see from all the diabetic motherfuckers running around. Gluttony's been here for a while. Poverty's here.
Who would be gluttony?
All the fucking people that are fucking diabetics fucking running around the FGC. Trust me, they got gluttony.
What about that one guy that was? Oh yeah, that one guy at the CEO.
Which guy?
Who's that one guy?
The kaiju that pulled the punko.
I don't even know what the hell punko.
Punko.
Yeah, he's just trying to say there was a really fat guy that pulled his shirt off.
Oh,
Marn?
He says Tupperware. Yeah, he says screw
Marn?
The Twitch
Tupperware.
Tweet,
no, Tupperware, whatever his name is.
Tupperware.
Tupperware.
Yeah, Tupperware. Whatever.
Gluttonware.
Oh, Tupperware.
He's a nice guy. I have no qualms with Tupperware. He's a nice guy.
Yeah, he doesn't bother me.
It was actually funny, but it was just that, like, I would have actually had hope that he would have been aware about that, you know, they're on Twitch. And if, like,
you know what? Here's the funny part. You know, I started this whole fucking wannabe WWE type shit with the putting the bounties on PL
back in the days. Yeah, I remember that.
The cantaloupes and all that. But it wasn't, you know, it reminds me of this. I wound up, it's just, oh God, he's got the video of it in the Tupperware. I don't know. Is that his name? Tupperware?
Tupperware.
Just Tupperware, I think.
I'd rather call him Tupperware. My grandmother was a Tupperware saleswoman. She used to go door to door selling Tupperware.
That's an honest job. It's an honest job.
Exactly. She wasn't begging like the FGC.
Right.
But what was I saying as I lose my fucking train of thought?
You still had about like 6 more cars.
No, I just gave up on the cars. You wrecked my car.
I don't know what you're talking about, man.
I'm sorry.
You wrecked the cars, man. Now I don't even know what kind of cars. It was a Pinto. There was a Nissan. There was a fucking... I took a bunch of sticks, some cigarettes. Nah, motherfuckers ain't got no cigarettes in the FGC.
Now, James, what was your first car, James?
My first car was a 72 Camaro Z28 with a 396 bored out 30 over. I did all the work on it myself when I could still work on a car.
Wow.
And what wound up fucking eventually happened is I blew the tranny after racing it about 4 or 5 times, traded it for a car with a guy cut out without giving me the title. So I drove that car into a wall just because it was still registered under him and he'd have to pay for it. Mm-hmm. And I drove it into a store.
If you could have it back today, would you?
What, the Camaro?
Yeah. Your first car.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. 72 Camaro? Yeah, I would definitely take it back.
That's such a fucking cool car.
I think I'm going to peace out pretty soon because I have some limited edition spicy pepperoni hot pockets I'd like to be eating right now.
Oh my God, my fucking hot pocket, man.
I'm a hot pocker.
I know you're a hot pocket, motherfucker.
Oh man, I wish I had some hot pockets.
At least there's nobody talking shit about hot pockets.
I gotta say though, about CEO, I don't know why Jabailey always seems to dress himself up in like wrestling belts and shit. He cannot sell worth shit.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
I mean,
he couldn't be able to sell a
Johnson. Did Kenny Omega make an appearance today or anything? I didn't see him. What did he do?
He was on Giant Bomb. He was on Giant Bomb's website. Giant Bomb's.
He was the CEO today.
Yeah, I know he was there. He's there. He was at Jabili's house, actually.
Yeah, I saw that. I was like, I don't know. Like I said, I mean, are any of these guys any good at the game or are they just here? I mean, guys seem to think that bringing in celebrities means something. I'm like, it's not going to grow because celebrities are here. People, first of all, especially the fact that, listen, I'm not trying to diss Kenny Omega, but I thought
it was an awful promo.
I thought he was a fucking vitamin.
Well, Kenny Omega, he's not good at Street Fighter V, but he knows how to play, and that's more than a lot of people expected.
Jamie Lee Curtis knows how to play.
Yeah, she does. She knows how to play. Yeah, she knows how to play. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Also, one of the other WWE members, forgot his name. He also plays and also has a YouTube channel.
Jamie Lee Curtis in True Lies. Man.
Yeah, man, Jamie Lee Curtis is my favorite WWE.
What a woman.
Superstar.
Nah, mine is Akuma the Butt Muncher. She's fucking amazing. And she's great at Street Fighter, too. And she's also good at eating ass.
Okay, I'm peacing out. See you guys. See you stream chat. See you James. See you other people. Everybody play Jackie Chan, Fist of Fire.
Fist of Fire.
And if you don't want to play Jackie Chan, Fist of Fire, play the Naruto games on the GameCube. Fuck you, bye.
Peace.
All right.
There it is.
Oh, God. Yeah, so, I don't know, man. I mean, I'm not trying to shit on CEO. I mean, part of me is saying karma's a motherfucker. He went after fucking final round so fucking gut-wrenchingly. And it's only...
Well, all the pressure's on him at this point.
Yeah.
He's got to run a great event.
I mean, I'll be honest with you. You know, one of the things that I say, and, you know, other people in the Illuminati have gotten mad that I say it, but I said, the fact of the matter is this. since Avid has been involved, NCR got in trouble with Capcom over the fucking, all of a sudden they were just like, yo, yeah, these guys are sponsoring us.
Yeah.
You know, Combo Breaker with Groper Gate. Now we got Car Breaking Gate. You know, it's three strikes, Avid. You've been involved with things three times, and three times things have gotten kind of fucked up. You know, maybe...
Not a good track record.
Maybe it's time, and here's what's really important. Maybe it's time for TOs to actually unite and start talking and dealing with each other civilly. Instead of
I think that's
dicks,
a great idea.
Instead of being dicks behind each other's back. Because, see, the FGC, you know, and Adonis from Korn, you know, put it out there on Twitter today, and he said it perfectly. You know, the FGC is just like Washington. You know, you got your senators and all that who basically do dick, which are your TOs.
Yeah. I see that.
And
yeah.
And they get the lobbyists, which are the sponsors, and the pissant people get shit on while these guys, all these guys have bodyguards. Yeah, we want to ban guns except for the guns that are protecting us.
Who would be the liberals?
There are no liberals.
It doesn't exist.
There ain't no such thing. Liberals, in other words, for a liberal is a pussy.
Regardless. That is the best analogy for the FGC I've ever heard in my life. That is amazing.
You know, but the problem is, just like in Washington, the Senate, you have your liberals and you have your Republicans and you're doing your battle back and forth and nothing gets done. And everybody talks all this bullshit. We got to accomplish this. We got to accomplish that. Let me tell you something. I'll tell you right now. If I personally... And I don't, you know, I had Noel Brown on a couple of weeks ago with that whole thing. And what he did was wrong. But when I see the situation to where it unfolded, I can't blame him. Does he deserve a ban?
It got blown out of proportion.
To be honest, no. He doesn't deserve to be banned. But.
It's Capcom's choice. It's their choice.
But now here's the thing. Not when you have an event. And that ruling, which is a knee-jerk reaction, if players were actually unified, I keep saying union a million times every episode, if all the top players said, if you ban Noel, we're not showing up to any more of your events, what do you think Capcom was going to do? What do you think they would do?
Honestly, I think nothing.
Pretty much.
So you're telling me Daigo, Justin, all these top players that are qualified, that we ain't showing up, we're done. You think
no,
they would just continue?
There's way too much money invested in this game, and there's so many players that...
But
the Capcom Pro Tour is a big deal.
This is the point of a union. Is because it happened to Noel today... Listen, I know for a fact Infiltration got some sticky fingers, too. Mm. Next, it could happen to him. When it happens to him, are they going to do the same thing, or are they going to sweep that one under the rug? I know a TO out there that happens to hit the sake a little too much, you know. And
probably swooping on the rug. I agree.
And that's the problem, and that's why this will never, ever, ever be esports.
Reputation is always a thing.
They're willing to sweep certain shit under the rug for certain people, but not all the people.
Because they don't want to get their reputation slain. That's why.
The FGC is a really funny anomaly because there's not a lot of people in it, but this is a scene built by enthusiasts, arcade enthusiasts, whatever it is.
But do those arcade enthusiasts exist? Because more than likely, it's online players.
I heard it all night. I felt like I had a fucking bee in my ear.
And is that me?
No, it was fucking the CEO stream again. It's playing. I got like fucking flashbacks from it.
Yeah, the after effects.
But
like when it comes to the arcade enthusiasts, where are those? Because more likely that's what because I mentioned this before, 10%. Because the 80% and 90% is usually the online warriors.
So Street Fighter V was on course to sell around 2 million copies, and they sold, 1.4 million?
That was back. So now I'm going to round it up to 2.
Okay.
I'm saying 2.
So, when you think about it, compared to, people that showed up to Evo, that's a really small percentage, you know.
What I've been telling people is this. When you look at the numbers that are coming to EVO, while the numbers are record numbers, and they're great numbers, the FGC is comprised of 15,000 people to 20,000 people worldwide. That's actually considering themselves gamers. You know,
that sounds like a safe number. That's a safe number.
If 5,000 people show up, all that happened, it wasn't an increase. You already had 20,000 in the pool. So, you know, the difference between last year's EVO numbers and this one is me taking a gallon of milk or handing you 4 quarts of milk. Well, now we got a gallon. But before we had 4 quarts. But either way you look at it, it's still a gallon.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the way the gallon came together is finally the sun and the moon aligned where a larger mass of people can get together at EVO. But
that's some sour fucking milk.
If you look, yeah, it's gonna stink like super swamp ass. I don't want to be in a casino that day.
Yeah,
you know, and it will never be like League of Legends. It'll never be to that level because of the fact that, again, when you hear, you know, when I joke around about thuggery and coonery and people, how can you say that? But the reality is this: when you think thuggery, what do you think?
CEO day one.
No, person,
crank.
Person.
Crank.
Person
crank,
wise.
From, crank from Ninja Turtles. Ninja Turtles.
Person wise, what kind of person? Let's be real here. What kind of person do you think when I say a thug?
I
mean, it.
Don't stutter it, guys. You know what you want to say.
I don't.
To be honest, Red Hook Projects.
Thank you, Red Hook Projects. Let's just say black.
I can't say black because, like, even from like other cultures,
I can't generalize someone like that. I really can't.
Think of the FGC and you hear them put out a rule of thuggery. Who do you think? How many white thugs are running around the FGC?
How many white people are in the FGC?
So you know,
James, it's you and me.
What my point is if as a community. You sit here and you try to say, we're going to weed out the thugs. So you want to take out some of the blacks. Some of the blacks. Not all the blacks. And then you're going to replace them with what? Because nobody new is coming.
Poetry.
I don't think when they say the blacks, you know, take.
I mean, I'm not saying they don't mean the blacks in a racial way. But when you think of thug, you think of the community is I don't want to say predominantly, but pretty close to blacks being the majority.
Yes.
I think it's just very good.
Yes, that's obvious. It's obvious.
You know, and to sit there and to alienate a section of black guys, Corn, for instance, saying they're thugs, and say, well, they're not part of the mold that we're trying to mold, you're going to remove them. And what are you going to replace them with? There's nobody on the waiting list to come into the FGC.
Yeah.
You're either going to get more thugs or nobody. So you better be happy with what you got and learn to control, as fucked up as that sounds, learn to control what you got, but do it in a way that's not coming off like a douchebag telling a person, don't be who you are. Let Corn be rowdy. But say, listen, be as rowdy as you want, but, you know, get all that hype WWE thing out. But like, I can't have you saying nigga this, nigga that. And I can't
you gotta keep it real, too. Yeah. You gotta keep it real.
You know, you gotta remember, you know, if you want to make a WWE persona, fine, do it. You want to take your shirt off and fucking hump the ground, do it. But
nobody's stopping you.
But at least know that you are working on building this, so keep in mind what you should and shouldn't do.
And you're just playing a video game.
And remember, at the end of the day, you're still just playing a video game.
You're just playing a fucking video game. I mean,
pretty much.
At the end of the day, you're like, oh, what did you do today? Oh, I won the video game tournament. Fucking cares.
Also, somebody basically mentioned about Asian thuggery. No, it exists, but not in North America.
No, you know what? And John Face Twitch, you're right. You know, I mean, we gotta look out for our fellow Mexican KOF players, because when Trump wins the election, he's building a wall and he's keeping them out. And that's half of our FGC outside of
Strickland. This might be controversial, but I'm definitely voting for Trump. I'm definitely voting for Trump.
I'm voting for him too.
Oh, I can't wait. I can't stand the crooked Hillary.
Let me also mention one thing. I've said this a few times already, and I'm probably going to be saying this pretty much almost until November. But basically, even though like there's people that's going to be voting for Trump and Hillary, I've said this in a sense where it's just a metaphorical. So if y'all guys end up doing this, shame on you. It's like playing double Russian roulette. Make sure you have the vodka. When you shoot yourself, whichever bullet comes first.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, what the fuck are you talking about? dude, whatever drugs you do, you ain't that far from me, dude. Hook my ass up. I was talking to a dude today, and I was like, dude, we were talking about drugs.
What's something to do with Donald Trump?
We were talking about drugs, and I told the dude, I was like, dude, I don't do drugs, but if there's a drug that you do it once and you're high forever, I'm on it.
Pepsi.
That's there not going to cut it. That's not
going to
cut it.
No, but I most of my time I just do shit posts. But the thing is more of the factor towards the ideal of how Donald Trump is and how Hillary is. So double Russian roulette was a good idea that I had thrown in. But yeah.
But yeah, you want a tangent, dude.
Like, yeah, do you like him or do you not like him?
I'm not trying to figure out. Are you gonna shoot yourself in the face instead of voting? Is that what you were saying?
Oh no, it's a metaphor. It's supposed to be used literally.
No, I'm pretty dumb, I guess. No, I think I'm pretty dumb.
Here's my thoughts about Trump in a nutshell.
Right.
He's racist as fuck.
No, he's not.
Okay, maybe that's not the right term.
Go ahead, Finish your thought.
Bigotry is more of a factor because of anybody that is not his culture. Secondly, he claims he's rich, but he's in debt. Everything that is in his fantasy world is a lie. And the thing is, he needs to be able to come in reality. Though, there is some things that hold some truth in what he says, and there are certain things I actually had found out, which basically exploits how the politics is now up today. So the fact that I am trying to at least give him some points into the fact that he is exploiting the whole system is more likely that's how Trump is going to win. When it comes to the voting, when it comes to bringing his opinion across on certain things, though sometimes is a bit dumbish, but then at the same time too, he does have some points in time of where it comes to sales pitches. Like, he talks like a businessman when he's on the podium.
Well, that's because he is.
Well, yeah, and at the same time too, he's not talking as a politician. So for some reason, So for people that are politicians, they're looking at him like he's a fucking idiot. But at the same time, too, he's getting away with it, and it's effective.
Well, the people want him. It's clear the people, most of the people want him. I mean, I really do respect, what's the fucking guy's name? Bernie Sanders, yes, thank you. Bernie Sanders, I really do respect him because he has a vision for the country.
Yeah.
You know, you really can't deny that. He has a legit vision. Hillary Clinton, I see another 4 years of Obama with her.
Yeah, that's what's going to be more likely because she's been basically trying to be able... What's messed up is that she contradicts like almost every time when she gets interviewed. And it's just not only that. Now there's a lot of dirt that is just like... coming out of
hold on a second. Somebody's asking me. Loomis is asking me about the UK leave. The UK. It's not the UK. It's England leaving.
Brevix or
unlike Trump, I'm not going to congratulate Scotland on leaving when they voted to stay. But the fact that England left, and I'll be honest, I've always been a person that believes personal achievement is the best achievement. I don't believe in commune mentality. I don't believe in everybody putting all our eggs in one basket because everybody has different outlooks on things. And for there to be one overseer literally over a continent, I never really vibed with. I never really vibed with the whole euro as far as a money denomination. Now, of course, what I think is going to happen is the pound's taking an ass whooping. Yeah. And it's going to take an ass whooping for a little while before it starts to rebound back. But the problem is now is how quick they're going to get out. They're kind of trying, because Cameron stepped down and he's like, listen, we're going to make this a process. We don't want to just jump out and fuck everything up. But now this goes to show you how fucked up the European Union is. They're already like, nah, motherfucker, get out now. Get out now. They're already trying to push him out as fast as they can. So it goes to show you how loyal were those countries to you in the first place.
Oh, were they even from the very beginning?
That's what I'm saying. They were never truly loyal. And, you know, I don't, like I said, that's why one of the great things, in, you know, as Trump thanked Scotland for their voting to stay out yet in, like an idiot, and Obama with his 51st state, and Bush reading books upside down, they're all idiots. You know, but...
I agree.
My thing is this, when you look at the United States, this is why we have federal laws and state laws. Mm-hmm. Each state gets to govern itself. We're not uniting Mexico and Canada with us. That would be a fucking disaster.
We're America,
and we were kind of the powerhouse. And we
would have to start acting like America.
Yeah. And we actually would have to eat the debts of those two to help them, like what happened with Greece. I'm sorry, Greece. You spent money like idiots. Now go sell your wives and daughters. Make the money back. Pay you back. You know.
Don't forget about China.
China owns America. Everything.
That's why I'm moving to China.
That's why I'm moving to China. My name's going to be
Jingming. You're moving to China?
Jingming Ling. I'm going to become like Cao Cao and take over China.
On blast show from China.
I don't know if I could do that. I'd probably be executed within an hour.
North Korea.
Now, they're saying that five more countries are already getting ready to start. Merkel's saying five countries will be backing out soon. France, Amsterdam... who else did they say? France, Amsterdam, France, Holland.
Germany?
No, she didn't say Germany. She said, like, a couple of the smaller...
Portugal or Spain?
Maybe it was Portugal, I think. I can't remember. She said, like, five countries would look to get out. Well, so what? It's their choice.
Yeah. Well, they voted for it.
Yeah.
You know, if they vote for... You know, people look at it and go... It's like, look... Whether all the people understood what they were, you know, that was the thing that I'm hearing now. Like, the youth of England now is looking and going, oh, I didn't know it would be like this.
Yeah.
Well,
you do your fucking research.
Someone said Sweden, Netherlands, France, and Greece.
Mm.
And I guess there's probably one more missing.
I don't know if Greece wants to break off right now. They're so fucking broke. If they break off, they're gone.
Did you guys see that anti-Trump rally where I'm assuming they were Mexican people, they started burning the American flag on American soil? I was fuming.
You know what it is? And this is the other thing. First of all, you know, to my immigrant friends, I love you all. I don't give a shit where you come from. Your country that you came from thinks you're a piece of garbage. They hate you. Because if they actually liked you... You would be there employed with insurance, making decent money, and living an okay life. But since they don't like you, they were like, oh, let this mutt go to fucking America. But yet you'll come here and you'll fly a flag for a country that kicked you out. Now, I'm all cool for national pride.
James, I was fuming. Like, I how dare you? Honestly, how dare you?
Well, this isn't the only time that a flag was burned. There was, like, probably a few other times.
Yeah, but this was a big fucking deal.
But the thing is this. It's like, all right, perfect example. A lot of my friends, like, I got a lot of friends from Salvador and shit. And, you know, they're always telling me, like, your people did this to... Whoa, motherfucker. Every World Cup, when you cheer for Spain, Those are the motherfuckers that raped your ancestors. Stop saying mine did. Listen, my German side was playing Game of Thrones for real.
Fucking Vikings.
We didn't discover shit. We discovered beer, motherfuckers.
I'm 25% German.
And my other half is Irish. And we discovered,
me too.
And we discovered fucking scotch. And we learned how to hit golf balls and, yes, and wear skirts.
You know, also Japan over in Okinawa, they want the American troops to be kicked out of their soil, right?
Yeah.
This has been probably more than so many times that U.S. Marines have been raping their women.
But here's the thing, getting back to Spain.
Yeah.
Now, when I watch the World Cup and I see my Latino friends cheering on, "Eh, viva la España!" and I go, "Whoa, whoa, 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 whoa." If somebody broke into my house and fucked my mother, I wouldn't give him a CEO belt.
Oh, hell no.
So why are you... You don't speak Gaelic, motherfucker. You don't speak German. You speak Spanish. You didn't wake up one day and just all of a sudden were like, what language do I want to speak? It's because Spain was fucking your family for hundreds of years. And yet you're going to cheer them on in the World Cup? And then they look at it and they think about it. And all of a sudden, like, Viva Almania! Woo, Germany! Yeah! See, now you see it differently.
Once you start shitting on people and you start catching them on their bullshit, they'll get defensive, all right. And then they'll start singing a different type of note.
You know, now, as far as... Is this fucking armchair economist really trying to explain... Who's an armchair economist? I'm a dude too. I'm explaining Christopher Columbus. In other words, my ancestors didn't rape nobody's ancestors. In fact, mine didn't own slaves either. So, in fact, we were slaves, Irish. We were the original slave over here. Fucking, I mean, I'm sorry to all my brothers out there, but.
Irish in a play.
It sounds fucked up, but better you than
no
us.
No Irish in a play.
Apparently, my ancestors were the necessary evil that pissed off a lot of Asians and Americans.
What is that?
Pearl Harbor.
Yeah, well, that was a.
It was a war.
No, that was. You guys, you know, back then you guys weren't good with the computer thingies, so you fucking didn't realize that like Hawaii was a different time zone from when you actually presented the declaration of war to Washington, and your ambassador went to fucking Washington.
James, please.
And your ambassador went to Washington, and he's like, "Oh, we declare war on you now." And the president's like, "Asshole, you bombed us 4 hours ago."
Oh, we did?
Oh, my bad.
Okay, but we still want to bomb you. But even from that, like, what's even fucking horrible is that this is the old gen till this day try to, like, freaking whack the cane on the new gen. "Oh, we did this to you guys at this time and third, blah, blah." Quite honestly, like, as much as that, you know, it's funny to be able to bash history on some other people that the fact that they also contradict themselves at times. But at the same time, too, like, you can't blame the new gen for basically doing this because they weren't a part of that history, like, fucking decades or even more than that.
I mean, look,
I agree.
I'm always open to listen to people's opinions, but I'm sorry. When I hear some of the newer generation, and I feel bad because, you know what? When I was growing up, perfect examples when you think of music, rock and roll, heavy metal, and all this shit.
Oh, yeah.
I grew up and I listened to my, you know, my dad always had 70s music on growing up. And the 80s came and that was my
Boston
years, you know, Boston, fucking Cat Stevens.
Yeah, Harry Cat Chapin, Stevens great.
You know, and I grew up partially in the AM era. And then FM came out, and then, you know, in the 80s, I got into the Billy Idols and the fucking Breakfast Clubs and all that other wackadoodle shit. Mm-hmm. And hip-hop started in the late 80s for me, and then I got into the 90s. I was getting into metal late 80s, 90s. And I always said to myself, I want to go with the times. I didn't want to be my father. Like, my father would hear my shit, "Turn that crap off." I didn't want to be that dude, so I tried to go with the time. And then I got into metal. And then at Slayer, I started to go, I think it's getting a little much.
What about Metallica?
Metallica was cool, and now they're pussies.
So was this before the Mortal Kombat days?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool. Go ahead.
So, you know, as time evolved, you know, I got to the point where black metal and double dip black metal and goth metal and all this, like, I listened to goth, I listened to everything, but then they took it to a new level. And at that new level, I'm just like, really? Even
garage metal.
Horror rap. I'm like, what?
Oh, is that the Fago people?
That's what?
Fago?
Horror rap. You know,
the clowns, right? Clown posse?
No. It's like this new thing, like straight up, like telling guys, you know, you're singing about like people getting killed, you know, your homies getting killed, and you're gonna go get revenge, and you dress up like
man, that sounds terrible.
Like you dress up like the Grim Reaper, and when you're doing it, and
James,
like,
you still listen to that?
No, I'm saying I drew that line at that point. Like with rap, I was like, yeah, you guys just lost me. And then in the metal era, once it got into the black metal. You know, guys are like, yes, I listen to this band. It's called Abscessed on My Ballsack. And I'm like, what? I'm like, what the fuck is that? And it's just a guy going, go, 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 go. And they're like, no, man, you got to listen to the guitarist. He's actually just playing classic music sped up. I'm like, all I hear is go, 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 go. It sounds like he's gargling on a cock. And I'm going,
we're screaming at it.
I guess... this is the paramount point for me where I can't follow the music no more. And I said, I'll just recede back into my 90s, and I'm in my 80s, in my 70s, and now on my phone, this is what I got on my cell phone right now. What music do I have? Let's see.
Red Hot Chili Peppers.
No. Actually, I have, Queen. let's see. I have David Bowie.
Queen.
Okay.
Eminem.
Yeah.
Faith No More.
Great band.
Foreigner. Jerry Rafferty, Iron Maiden, John Carpenter, I like all his fucking music, Pink Floyd, Run DMC, Typo Negative, and the soundtrack from the movie The Warriors.
What about the Fugees?
No.
Fugees look good.
No, I don't like
them. That's a good list. That's a respectable list.
That is a good list, yeah.
You know, and who gives a fuck? Music is all auto-tuned. No, it was not auto-tuned back in the day. Now it's auto-tuned. Now everything's auto-tuned.
Yeah, because there was not that much auto-tunes, and I'll be able to talk about that as well, because...
The safety dance?
The safety dance? What the hell is that?
Safety dance? You don't know the safety dance is? Oh, damn.
Dance. I can't play any music on here.
Okay, the thing is that this is the music I had been listening to throughout my whole time. 90s was rap, then went to metal, then it went to punk, and then there was J-pop, and also...
J-pop. Who plays J-pop?
Not in America. Not America. It's more international. It's not Americanized. But if we was to talk about for J-pop, it's usually Gak, Larkin, Seal, TM Revolution, Julian K.
I watched Hitomi Tanaka. Hitomi Tanaka. She's my favorite.
Fisted in All Star.
So that means that, I think...
Fist of North Star.
Ninja Scroll.
Oh, yeah. By the time of the 90s, that's when people were starting to get used to checking out anime. I think those were two of them. Dragon Ball Z.
Dragon Ball Z wasn't around yet.
So I had nothing to give my sister for her birthday this year because I was fucking broke. Mm-hmm. So I gave her my, you know the game Catherine?
Oh.
Yeah. I had the special edition with the pillow and the fucking t-shirt and all that shit. I just put it in a bag and gave it to her for her birthday. She loved it.
Well, Catherine was like a great one hitter. Honestly, I have to say.
Oh, the game was terrible. I hate that game.
Really?
Yeah, I absolutely hate it. I think it's terrible.
Yeah. I mean, I guess because like the thing was that there was a mix, but like most of the time I've been hearing like it was a pretty good game to some.
Albino, the problem is my BMI license expired about 2 years ago, and I didn't renew it. And I didn't want to renew it because they wanted $10,000 to renew it. And I'm like, fuck all you guys.
$10,000?
Yeah. If you want me to play music and be able to play it with royalty free and all that other bullshit, I ain't shelling out $10,000. And then when YouTube got bought out, they had a BMI license, and then it got pulled, and now they got this supercomputer on this fucking thing that, like, rips the shit apart. And it's like, yeah, I heard 3 beats from fucking the Go-Go's, so your fucking thing's flagged.
Yeah, YouTube is just a complete robot. Like, there's no fucking humans. Yeah. And that's the problem with YouTube nowadays. There's not going to be no type of operator to be able to assure that there's any issues with anybody's content. They're just pretty much saying, fuck you, just let us know.
If you don't like it, then too bad. That's what they're saying.
That's what they're saying.
Yeah.
It's the way it is. YouTube is going to be the way it is. They give a fuck if you have whatever it is, you know. If you ever put a Nintendo 64 review up or something, fuck it, who cares? They don't give a fuck. They're going to do what they want.
And then another thing is, too, any small guys as like me that is trying to be able to get into YouTube or fortunately has started.
Don't do it.
Just go to just go on Twitch. Start out from there. Save yourself the trouble. Don't kill yourself off of YouTube. It's gonna die eventually.
GeForce. That was actually good.
GeForce is actually pretty good.
Yeah, actually, that was alright.
You know what's really funny about Facebook, too, is that most of the people that use Facebook these days are, you know, over 30 years old.
Yeah, because they were 9 years old when they started using it.
Exactly. And most people just left. They left Facebook. And I think Facebook is... Oh, man. I think Facebook's terrible for society.
Listen, the problem with Facebook is people put shit out there.
Shouldn't be putting out there.
Yeah, dude, listen. All right, cool. You know, I know a little lady out there that put out the question about, like I said, and the question was simple. If you knew somebody didn't like you, would you leave and not deal with them, or would you want to know why? And everybody all of a sudden, and I got my feel for everybody at that time, because guys were like, I'd leave. I want to know why. I said, I want to destroy their lives. I want to wreck everything about them.
Hmm.
And they're like, why so nasty? I'm like, because if you hate me, I have nothing but hate for you.
Right.
I mean, why would I like somebody that's basically telling me you don't like me? Well, maybe if you were more like what they wanted, then I wouldn't be me.
You wouldn't be with them then.
Yeah, that doesn't make any fucking sense. Because I had that type of scenario ended up happening to me because somebody freaking just randomly hate me. I'm like, oh, why they hate me? Oh, well, if they're looking for something to hate, well, guess what? I'm going to provide it.
I mean, it is for old people. Because like I said, it's for the old people. Because, you know, I know people that were 30 years old that were getting into it back then, and now they're 50s. You know, how old is Facebook now?
I want to say 2005?
Around there.
Yeah, so it's like 10 years old.
It was close to the MySpace era.
No, whatever.
You know, and Google's the same thing, and it's just a fucking browser, and they expanded out into everything. Amazon, the same thing. And these tentacles that they put out, you know, after a while, even I look at, like, I liked MySpace.
MySpace was cool because you could play your own song. Like, you set up a song. Fun. Yeah, MySpace was pretty cool.
And then it turned into just a music thing, and I was like, "Yeah, this sucks."
Well, Facebook took over. Yeah. Facebook definitely took over.
It crushed it. Yeah.
It made MySpace completely irrelevant. I have no idea.
2004, Facebook came out,
and I have no idea why the fucking NSYNC guy bought MySpace. What the fuck was he thinking? I have Justin no Timberlake? Idea. Yeah, Timberlake, yes. He bought MySpace.
Well, yeah.
Good luck.
I didn't actually get it either.
Nothing but bad luck for that guy. MySpace has not gone anywhere.
Nope. Apparently it was supposed to be something like how to become a musician 101 type of, you know, website. The musicians there. And
who's drinking what over there?
I'm drinking.
I figured that. I hit the bottle.
I'm pouring myself a shot.
You know what's good about me hearing that bottle? That means my sound is better than the CEO stream.
Hey!
That's gonna happen.
Oh, man, I'm bad. I'm going to hell. I mean, like Like I said, I hope he fixes everything tomorrow.
Dude, hell ain't a bad place to be.
Everybody is going to hell eventually. I'm going
to
be there.
I'm going to heaven, and I'm going to look down at all you motherfuckers and say, you thought I was the dick, huh? Look who's the dick now. Lazy Moon with Squad.
What was this? Maybe
I want to go to Colorado. I want to move there and live there.
Colorado, why smoke weed? Smoke weed every day.
I don't give a fuck about smoking weed. Smoking weed's whatever. I don't even like smoking weed.
I don't either.
I smoke weed and I get really paranoid.
But I do. I do got to say this. I mean, now a couple of weeks ago, it's Eddie Corona's birthday. I don't know who the fuck Eddie Corona is.
What is that, a drink?
No.
I mean, it was a drink.
Dude, Eddie Corona. I don't know who he is, but it's happy birthday, Eddie Corona.
Happy birthday.
When I did the episode with Noel Brown coming on, the EVB team actually turned around and they complained to Ultra Arcade, who, you know, I got their sponsor up here on the screen.
Mm-hmm.
And they also complained to Big E Gaming. EVB Bizzle and Evilette, which is like, the husband and wife or boyfriend and girlfriend maybe of the team. And I've been supporting, you know, they're specifically a Mortal Kombat team. And shout outs to these guys, Katana Prime, Big D, Newbie, Gross, who else? Jeez, who else is down there?
Katana Prime is a great guy.
Yeah, no, they're all great guys. And I've always supported these guys for years. When I initially set out, and I'll tell you my little secret. I laid out probably between 40 and 30 grand, 40 and 50 grand that I said from 2012 till now, I was going to donate to events and whatnot. That's why coming up for NEC, I gave $1,000 for Guilty Gear. Coming up at the next NEC.
Why did you do that?
Because that's how I am.
You just like support
the scene. Yeah, I was actually wondering about that because Ice Cold basically posted something about you guys.
For NEC, this next NEC coming up, I put $1,000 pop bonus in for Guilty Gear.
I'm saying that's incredibly generous of you.
Amazing. But my thing is this, like, the money would have gotten spent a lot quicker had it not been for dicks. Like, I offered a specific person 15 grand for Marvel back going a couple of years now, and they told me they couldn't because my show was toxic. I'm like, so you can't take my money and give it to somebody else because I'm
toxic. Can I guess who it is?
Go ahead.
Fnatic.
No. No, it was a sponsor. It was a TO.
It was a
TO. Really?
No, I'm not going to mention who. I'm not going to put him on blast.
Okay.
But you know,
he's a TO though.
But then, yeah. But from that point on, I said to myself, you know, I'm going to give my money out the way I want, when I want. And those that are dicks to me, I'm never going to offer you.
Hmm.
You know, but Big E's always been cool. Every event I go to, I mean, people bitch and moan about things here and there. But he's a straight shooter.
Yes.
I see how he, you know, all the events that I've been to, I watch everything. People just think I roam around and float around like the drunken fucking father from Hoosiers. But I actually pay attention to everything. And I watch how TOs talk with people, you know, what TO talks down to people. And no, not Rick. It wasn't Rick the Hotter. He wasn't even around yet. This is going back a couple of years ago. You know, what I said is, you know, I'm going to lay out 50 grand, and my plan was 2012 to whenever to kill off all the money. Just give it away. And I've sent players to Evo. You know, I dropped 10 grand on shirts and gave them away at events. You know, and I, you know, I've been throwing little things here and there. So with this one, I think Guilty Gear hasn't been getting the love that it should. That's why I picked it.
Cause right.
People were sitting there going, well, what about MK? I'm like, motherfucker, go win Evo. It's got $50,000 upstate.
They're yeah, the they new game coming out. The new game's coming out next year.
Yeah, 50,000 or 51,000 is not much of a difference, motherfucker. So my $1,000 will go to something where it actually makes an impact on the scene. Yeah. I keep telling people, Yeah, I'm a Mortal Kombat guy. I can't deny that. I'm also a Street Fighter guy. I can't deny that. I'm also a KI guy. I can't deny that. I like fighting games.
You love the scene. You have a real passion for the scene.
And I like to see the scene grow. I don't need pats on the back. I'm not Alex. I'm not down at CEO telling people, pay attention to me, what I did.
Because look how great I am. Yeah.
Look at me!
Look how good I am. Look what I do. It's frivolous. It's very frivolous, and it's wrong.
And for me, I said, I ain't going to lie. The money's dwindling. So I said, I'm going to start trying to, make some games that aren't getting their fair shine. And I think, $1,000 in there. Hopefully somebody else will come around and throw another $1,000 in. So anyway, getting back to what the real issue was here. So, now I got this girl, and I got this EVB girl, and this Bizzle, as you see on my shirt here. Complaining to them about my show being toxic. So I reached out to them on Twitter and I said something to them about, what I said to them was, if you guys want, I'll put your logo up on the show. And their response was pretty much, we don't want to deal with toxic people like you.
Who are these people?
EVB is the name of their sponsor.
What?
They're a sponsor down in Florida.
Have they ever seen Filthy Frank?
It's not even.
They're more toxic than how OBS is.
It's not. The point is that when they said that to me, I wasn't offended. I said, you don't want to be advertised on my show. Okay, I understand.
That's fine. Yeah, but you don't say you're toxic. That's the line.
And that's kind of where I drew the line. So I was going through my miscellaneous shit that I've acquired over the year. Like, I go to events and, I'll help cleaning up and shit when everybody's gone. And lo and behold, I keep the shit in a pile. And if somebody says, hey, you find my phone or you find this, yeah, I got it. And I just so happened to go through a pile of shirts and I found my EVB Evil Biz shirt, which is his shirt. So now he's getting free advertisement here. I like the way it looks, actually.
Might as well keep it.
I think I'll keep it. This is my game of this is my Game of Thrones thing. In fact, what? Maybe if he brings his guys up to like NEC, I'll pick one of my players against one of his players, and if he beats me, he gets this back. If not, I go out to the parking lot, piss on it, and light it on fire.
Would he want it recorded?
It would be recorded. It always gets recorded.
And you gotta drink a beer while you're doing it.
Oh, yeah. I drink a beer while it's rough.
Obviously.
If I had one now, I'd drink it, but I'm trying to be sober because I got work in the morning.
Yeah, I got you. I got you.
But again, it's like certain people in this scene judge other people. Like, I never, even like Alex in the Hadou and even Keats in Ski Sonic, I never judged them. My attitude about these guys are from direct dealings with them.
Yeah.
And from the impression that I get with dealing with somebody, I base that opinion off of that. And I'll tell you, like, the first time I met Ski Sonic, we had an argument, and the argument went, he was drunk. He was saying how bad
the show drinks.
Was. Yeah, he drinks and smokes weed too.
cool.
But he was a little tipsy, and he says to me that the MK scene should just leave the community and start their own thing because nobody in the Capcom community wants him around.
No, that's fucked up. That is fucked up.
And I was kind of like, well, who the fuck are you? You look like that's where I started. That you look like a fucking Muppet. I had talked to other people.
Fozzie Bear.
I had talked to other people.
Call him Gonzo.
And what wound up happening was, through talking to other people, they said, you don't know him. Da, 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 da. I said, maybe you're right. And I tried to get to know him. But, when I had brought Larry on the show after the final round fucking episode.
Yes.
And Ski Sonic was out there on Twitter saying, why would you go on this guy's show?
Well, fuck that. Fuck him. That's bullshit. That's bullshit.
I even went to an event. I think it was ECT last year, and I saw him. And he actually, ironically, he gave Noel Brown a hug, and I was right there. And I turned around to him, joking around, trying to break the ice. I said, hey, no hug for me, and he ran away like a bitch.
Listen, final round, that was not all Larry's fault. I don't think so. Because think about it, that was the first real tournament, the first real Capcom Pro Tour tournament. The guy had 1,000 players in the bracket.
And if it wasn't for him, these guys wouldn't have learned because they would have all tried to max it out. Now they all got exactly. It down to 600.
He was the training dummy, you know. He was the guinea pig.
Yeah. You know, but, you know, my point is, it's like, you know, I don't have nothing personal against Evil Biz. He don't know me. I don't know him. I know his players because I've been helping his players since the beginning of MK, since they've been coming around. You know, and I would be willing to barter for the shirt if he wants to get the shirt back. I mean, it's got my sweat juices in it now, so it's probably going to make him win if he plays in a game. I'll put one of my players up against his players at NEC. And, you know, he could be big deal. It was just one player. We're not doing teams because I can't put a team together.
In Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter 5?
Mortal Kombat.
MKX.
All his players are MK players.
All right.
You know, but we'll see what he says, if he's willing, if he's game, or if he's fucking too pansy and wants to say, keep the shirt. I don't care because you wear it. It stinks now. I bathe, so it smells pretty good. Yeah, you know, so, if you want.
James, I have a question about Tom Brady.
What about him?
So I'm a big Tom Brady fan. I love his stream. I think the guy is hilarious, but is he mostly an act? Or is he really like that?
You know what? I don't know.
Really?
Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't.
Because I think he's hilarious.
He gets in moods where he has these little nervous breakdowns. And then sometimes he goes into it. It's like me. Sometimes I just go fucking... Sometimes you see me on Twitter. I just wake up in the morning. I'm like, fuck shit, suck my cock and cut my balls, lick my asshole, cunts. And that's it. And then people are like, okay, it's good morning. And then the very next sentence, I'm like, yeah, hey, I had an epiphany last night. And I feel really well. And they're like, just cursing people out. Yeah, you know.
Brady
kind of does the same thing.
Yeah, I love Brady. I love his stream. I still think it's funny that his Twitch stream is called MK Rio versus Tom Brady.
Yeah.
You still use that old... I don't think Rio lives in New York anymore, right?
No, he lives here.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
okay,
in fact,
cool.
He'd probably wind up being one of my players if I keep going.
Yeah, that guy's godlike. He's great at Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, he's doing life now, though. So, I mean, but he still plays. He still streams all the time. You know, go check out his stream, MK Rio /Twitch/MKRio.
Yeah, Rio's great. He's a great, great player.
Subscribe.
Does he play Molina?
Subscribe. He plays everybody.
Yeah, I bet.
Now, it's like, but it's like, what's funny is he, sometimes I really can't tell, man. With him. Sometimes, like, I'll turn into his stream and I'm like, he's just fucking trolling. Sometimes I'm like, I think he's having a fucking real nervous breakdown. Like, with the punching of the monitors and shit like that, I'm like, wow, man, that you're not doing on purpose. I can tell you that right away. Nobody punches a monitor on purpose.
No. Unless you have the money for it, then that's one thing. Or unless that's a used monitor.
Unless you buy another one.
Yeah.
No, because I've seen like people, they'll end up basically using a prop that will look like it's in good condition, but internally is like completely like broken. And they'll just end up using it for just for their complete antics on their videos. So, if that would be the case, like if you've seen like anybody that has like pure hatred coming out of nowhere, and especially even in the matches, then that's kind of like saying, nah, that shit ain't staged.
Yeah, I agree. I agree with that. Yeah. Certainly.
Tom never trolls. He's just old enough to not give a shit. That's partially where I side with him. I'm like, that's where, like, sometimes I get baffled. Because I'm like, he's supposed to be that way. But sometimes I wonder. You know, I've had conversations with him where he'll tell me, you know, fuck this game. I'm done with it. I'm moving on, yada, yada, yada. And then all of a sudden, a week and a half later, I get, do-do-do-do, Tom Brady is streaming. And I go on the stream, and he's like, you motherfuckers, you got to fix this piece of shit character. Who the fuck are you?
Because he, He loves playing Sub-Zero, but Sub-Zero sucks in MKX.
Yeah.
It's so fucking funny.
I think it's just more likely, like,
I'm done everybody with this character. Not. I'm done. I'm fucking done with it.
The best character. With Tom, the best with Tom was the Bo Rai Cho era. Yeah.
Was it is that Deli Alliance? Are you talking about Deli
Alliance? No, I'm talking MKXL.
Okay, okay.
I'm going to get Bo Rai Cho, and it's going to be like the Bo Rai Cho back in the day. I never really gave a shit about Sub-Zero. It was always about Bo Rai Cho, and I'm going to puke, piss, shit, and fart all over you guys. And I'm going to do infinites that probably aren't going to be in the game, Tom. I'll find them. And then I think he used them for like a week.
Yeah, Tom is... That guy is something else. Like he's such an integral part of the FGC. Lord Brady.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah. The guy is great. The guy is great.
Of course, the pool party gets shut down as soon as I arrive.
Is Triforce on tonight?
Nah, Triforce. I don't know. I know he's back.
No, he was here. He was on the chat.
Yeah, I talked to him last night actually.
Wow. People took a shit in the pool. At one point, I saw the floater. People are animals.
Was it a Snicker bar?
Floating Snickers at the pool at CEO.
He was kind of concerned that if Smash Play is going to basically throw some shit into the hotel rooms.
See, now, here's the thing that's fucked up. Now, look, I break Alex's balls, but I try not. I have no idea. This is what I'm not going to mention names of the people. I have no idea why people are still supporting Shemaley. Happened last year, too, with the pool party, and the stream was shit so far. People the same shit last year. What they need to do is fix their goddamn stream. Most of the time when a stream goes down, a few are quick to say, well, the hotel has shitty Wi-Fi or something to that effect. But the production value going into most of these events... Now have they never considered spending a little bit more money to set up some sort of hotspot? Most companies like AT&T, Verizon, et cetera, have services where you can get fast fucking internet virtually anywhere.
They put fucking in there.
In the grand scheme of things, it's not really that expensive. Seems like TOs like Jeff Fairley are more concerned with making as much money as they can and don't give a fuck about the spectator. Every year except our first year.
What a question.
Year. Every year except our first year. James. Well, this is James. James speaking the truth.
Jeez.
It's what I do best. Not me, by the way. It's somebody else, James. Jeff Fairley doesn't care for the FGC or the spectators. All he cares about is money. Jeff Fairley is Illuminati confirmed. Stay woke. At least you have a pool party to go to. And this guy says they shut the pool party like last year. I'm just gonna get fucked up tomorrow. Someone threw a trash can in the pool.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Well, last year someone dropped a deuce in the pool, and that was why the pool party got stopped. Really?
Somebody said
really? I thought it was because of the DJ and noise complaints. Someone took a shit in the pool at that point. I saw the floater. People are animals.
You were there last year?
No,
you were there, James?
I'm reading people's people's posts.
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn, that's hilarious.
Let's see what this one says. Hot as fucking Florida, and someone is breaking into cars. What the fuck? What in the fuck? Good thing 60% of the people at CEO did not drive here.
Florida sucks. I hate Florida.
Let's see the comments. I drove. Shit. Where at the venue? Oh, shit. That sucks. They are tweeting it on Twitter. Check your cars at the venue because there are 13 car confirmed break-ins. Okay.
Oh, they're tweeting on Twitter. Oh, that's nice. I thought they were tweeting on Facebook.
Okay, just checked mine. All good. But I want to make another PSA. Cockroach spotted in room. Well, that's Florida. That's Florida.
Yeah.
Florida fucking sucks.
Fucking nasty. I can't take roaches. Cries. So, you know, that's a chick. Let's see. It might be the chick in the room, actually. Fucking nasty. I can't take cockroaches. Yeah, I just bitched at the front desk for another room. Won't get one until tomorrow. Wait, hotel main venue? What the fuck? People need to cut it. Jesus Christ. Sad face. I noticed one time someone tried to break into my car at UFG T9 or 10.
Oh, wow, what a nice guy.
Found the rusty car, picked my car window, snapped the shit up with quickness. You're at CEO? No. Is it at the resort venue? I drove here. I don't know anyone is able to break into a car with all the people around. Really? Damn, my car
it's
was
fucking
parked.
Florida.
Damn, my car was parked way
Florida
in the back.
Florida sucks.
Way in the back for 6 hours. I'm all good, though. Ain't got shit in my car to steal, so they probably said, fuck it. I thought you said you couldn't afford to go. This is where people start. This is where
wait,
people start. This is where people start knocking on each other. Like, oh wait. Carpooled with us and saved your money on gas and tolls. And I guess since you said you won't, your car won't make it. If you rented a car, which would have also saved you money. 13 break-ins. Goddamn. It's all good. I needed my car anyway. Going to theme park hopping Monday with passes. This is the same guy that said he's broke. I had to come, though, because I had to meet Mondo and Kenny Omega. Was really a last-second decision. Sorry for blowing up your post. Oh, okay. Oh, told people karma is a mofo. I actually posted that one.
Why the fuck you lying?
Hey guys, I want to leave. Thank you for.
Fuck you lying.
It was cool talking to all of you tonight, but I gotta go.
All right, man.
All right, guys, have a good night.
All right, I'm gonna let you go too, Crowley. I'm ending this. I'm in ending all this shindig.
Yes, I know y'all guys gotta sleep.
Yeah, I gotta sleep. It's 4:30.
All right,
guys.
I'll keep you guys up to speed about with day two.
Yeah.
All right,
man.
Good ones.
Later. So anyway, guys, let me just finish this up here. Most of the people here are from here, so they drove. My car was broken into at CEO 2011. Luckily, I had a kill switch. What other? So that was a couple of posts. What else do we got here? Another reason I refuse to. Here we go. This is another thing we were talking about. A player mentioned the guys talking around sitting to pee. The conversations on Facebook. What do we got? I'm parked right in front of my house tonight. Oh, God. All right. So, anyway, guys, hopefully things will head out better tomorrow for CEO. I'm wrapping it up because my ass has gotta get some sleep because I've been up all fucking day and I just worked a 16-hour shift. So I'm out. Peace. I'll put this up on YouTube later.